Hello everyone, my name is Professor Nyazi, and now we're going to be discussing how to solve some quadratic equations. There are various methods on solving quadratic equations. One of them is factoring, another one is completing the square, another one is using the quadratic formula. Well, first, we're going to be doing various methods. I'll use this example for x squared minus 2x is equal to 0. We want to solve for x. Well, we can notice that there's actually two terms in this equation and that they both share two entities in common. A 2, because 4 is really 2 times 2. This 2 here and an x, because x squared is really x times x. So this can be rewritten as 2 times 2 times x minus 2 times an x, which is 0. So I can take out a 2x from each of these right here. And when I factor that out, I'll bring this here, a 2x comes out. So then what remains is a 2x here minus this 1 is equal to 0. Here's our check. You can always check if you factored correctly by just sending it back through. You should restore the original quantity that you had before. So let's check it. Let's send this 2x back into this. So that's 4x squared minus 2x, that equals 0. We have restored our original quantity, that's 4x squared minus 2x. So whenever you're factoring and you're on a test or an exam and you don't have a way to look up whether you did it correctly, just make a guess, send it through, and if it restores the original quantity, you did it correctly. If it does not, then think again. You made some type of error. But that's okay. We never give up. Now, once we're at this phase, we can set this quantity equal to 0 and this other quantity equal to 0. This we can set equal to 0 and this we can set equal to 0. So I can set 2x equal to 0. That would imply when I divide both sides by 2 that x is equal to 0 because 0 over 2 is 0. And setting this one equal to 0, this other term, 2x minus 1 equal to 0, I add 1 to both sides, so I get 2x is equal to 1. I divide both sides by 2, so I get x is equal to 1 half. So here are two solutions to this equation. Let's do another example. Let's solve another quadratic equation about 2x squared plus 7x is equal to 4. I want to solve for x again. Now, we can't do this whole trick of pulling something out and utilizing this zero principle rule. We actually have to bring this over here. This constant term, we get the 2x squared plus 7x minus 4, set this equal to 0. We're wondering if we can factor this fellow somehow. One way to try and do it is to complete the square. Another way to do it is to use the quadratic equation. Another way to do it is brute force factoring. At this moment in time, I believe it'd be a great way to introduce completing the square. Now, completing the square, I'm not going to review the theory on how to complete the square. I'm assuming you know or have been introduced to completing the square, and I'm going to just do it for you. If it is requested, I can go over the theory of completing the square in another video. However, step one, you have to make sure that the coefficient in front of the quadratic term is 1. So step one, we have to divide both sides by 2. So 2x squared plus 7x minus 4 is equal to 0. I have to divide this side by 2 and this side by 2 so that I can get rid of that 2 coefficient right there. Because when I distribute the 2 to each term, I get 2x squared all over 2 plus 7x all over 2 minus 4 all over 2 is equal to 0. These 2's cancel here, so I have x squared plus 7 over 2x minus 2 is equal to 0. All right, that was step one. Now we have the one here. Good. Step two. We're going to send the constant term packing. By that, I mean we're going to send it to the other side of the equation. I'm going to get this equation, and I'm going to add a 2 to both sides. So I get x squared plus 7 over 2x is equal to positive 2 over here. And I'm going to suggestively leave a little space right here because we're going to be doing something there. Step 3. This is the completion of the square step. And so I'll designate it in these brackets. As you hopefully know, the way you complete the square is you get the b value, the linear coefficient, which in our case is 7 over 2. You divide that in half, and you square the whole thing. Whole thing squared. Now, this, when we multiply by reciprocals, since this 2 is really a 2 over 1, it really breaks down to 7 over 2 times the reciprocal 1 over 2 quantity squared, because the reciprocal of 2 is 1 over 2, and we multiply top and bottom by 1 over 2, the denominator cancels to 1. Now I have 7 over 2 times 1 half, which becomes 7 over 4, and when I square 7 over 4, I get $49.16. And so I'm going to add $49.16 to both sides of the equation. Plus a $49.16, plus a $49.16. Now, just working on this side, if I multiply top and bottom here by 16, I get 32 plus 49 all over 16. And 32 plus 49, geez, I'm not too good at mental arithmetic. Well, if I make that a 31, that's 50. So 50, 60, 70, 80, and I still have that 1, which is a 81 all over 16, and that's really a 9 squared all over 4 squared, okay? This breaks down to 3 squared, which is what 9 is, quantity squared, all over 2 squared, which is 4, quantity squared. This breaks down to 3 to the 4th power, all over 2 to the 4th power. Okay? So then we can bring out that 4th power, 3 over 2, all to the 4th power. That's what the right-hand side will be. The left-hand side is this x squared plus 7 over 2x plus 49 over 16. And notice that if I bring the party over here, that means we can factor. We know how to factor that. I'll rewrite it for good measure. X squared plus 7 over 2x plus 49 all over 16. This, I claim, is equal to x, and what is our b? Our b over 2 reduces to a 7 over 4, so plus 7 over 4 quantity squared. I claim that these are equivalent. Here's your check. X plus 7 over 4 quantity squared is equal to x plus 7 over 4 times x plus 7 over 4. Whenever we FOIL those, I get x squared plus 7 over 4x plus 7 over 4x plus, you guessed it, 49 over 16. This is a weird x. So 7 over 4x plus 7 over 4x is 2 7 over 4x. So this is equivalent to x squared plus 2 7 over 4x plus 49 all over 16, and that 2 and that 4 cancel because 4 is really 2 times 2, cancel, and so this reduces to, you guessed it, what we have above, x squared plus 7 over 2x plus 49 over 16, so we did it correctly. This is in fact correct factorization. Now, we can kill this problem off here. Now we know that the right-hand side from there is 3 over 2 to the 4th power, and the left-hand side is this x plus 7 over 4 quantity squared. This is equal to that. We can solve this by taking the square root of both sides. Square root. Square root. This makes this x plus 7 over 4. And this makes it plus or minus 3 over 2 squared. Why is that? Well, I'll tell you why. If you give me a second to erase, the reason for that is the square root of 3 over 2 to the 4th is equivalent to the square root of 3 over 2 squared times 3 over 2 squared, because the exponents add. And then this is just the square root of 3 over 2 squared times square root of 3 over 2 squared. This reduces just to 3 over 2 times 3 over 2, which is equivalent to 3 over 2 squared. That's why we get that. The plus or minus is because we're taking an even root. 2 is even, so it gets plus or minus. If it was a 4th root, we'd put plus or minus. If it was a 16th root, we'd put plus or minus. If it was a 100th root, since 100 is an even number, it would be plus or minus. Okay? And so, to solve for x, I get x is equal to negative 7 over 4 plus or minus this 3 over 2 squared. So, when we elect to add, x is equal to negative 7 over 4 plus. And I can distribute that square, I get 9 over 4. And the negative root, and actually we can keep going, 7, 8, 9, that's 2 over 4, and so that's 1 half. This is one of the answers, is 1 half is one of the roots. And another one, when we elect to subtract, x would be equal to negative 7 over 4 minus 9 over 4. Okay. And so whenever I subtract that, I get negative 16 over 4. When I distribute 4 into there, 4 can go into 16 how many times? 4, 8, 12, 16. So if it goes in there 4 times, and that negative comes along for the ride. So our solution is that the roots are 1 half and negative 4. This is just two various examples on how to solve quadratic equations. One of them was by factoring and setting equal to 0, and the other one was by completion of the square.